Days after the storm ravaged parts of Long Beach Island, it's now deserted and desolate. Access is limited to mostly first responders, cleanup crews, and utility workers. Most residents followed the evacuation order, so there are few people here now, with the exception of Helen and Wes Potter, who chose to ride out the storm at their home.
All the tide in the morning came up, and it didn't come in the garage or anything. The ocean and the bay kind of met. So I figured that high tide that evening would be bad. Maybe I'd get a foot, maybe two. Well, we got 3 to 4. So, you know, I came down and found the cars flooded out. They're ruined. But, you know, the rest got a lot of wet stuff, but we're okay.
In the street, you see hot water heaters, gas heaters, gas grills that people have just stuck in for the, you know, until they close up the house. A lot of them haven't closed up, so unfortunately, they've really lost everything.
Shortly after our interview, the Potters left their island home when the National Guard arrived to pick them up. But we also found some business owners on the island who were surveying their damage and counting their losses.
We had a high water mark in the store of 4 feet throughout the entire store. Lots of damage. I'm just coming over every day, however I can, to just get in here and try and salvage what's left, and especially let the buildings breathe. We've got 5 stores on the island, so each one of them had at least 4 to 6 feet of water in them.
Cleanup work has begun here in the central part of Long Beach Island, so a lot of the debris that littered the streets has been removed. But farther south, the destruction is widespread and severe.
There are some homes off their foundations. The trailer park was moved and pushed into a big pile of trailers. There's boats all over the place. The homes that were on pilings on the beachfront in Holgate, the sand under them has been wiped out, so now they're standing in the middle of the air with nothing underneath them, sitting on their piling, so the damage is extensive.
Among the challenges that lie ahead, natural gas lines under LBI will likely have to be rebuilt. Rebuilding is what business owners and residents plan to do, but that will take time and an extraordinary amount of resources. For NJ Today, I'm Desiree Taylor on Long Beach Island.